give us a concise definition of what share pledging is and why you have done this research now at this particular time?
So pledging is pretty much like any other collateral. Pledging of shares is like keeping any other property on collateral to raise money. The only difference is that by virtue of being shares which are kept with the financial institutions as collateral, the value of the shares fluctuate because they are listed on the stock exchanges. So what happened was that during COVID times, you know, the share prices of many companies fell, which were external to the business of the company. It was a totally unforeseen circumstances. And because of which many of the financial institutions ended up selling the pledged shares in the market, we saw many high-profile companies losing their shareholding. Despite these cases, the phenomenon remained very, very popular. This paradox, you know, this anomaly, this paradox of negative popular perception, yet popularity of the phenomena, this piqued our interest in the topic, and we set on a journey to study various aspects of pledging.
Explain to us what this exactly means on a global scale. Do we see this in other countries and other markets?
Yes, Ramya, we do see it in countries like the United States, China, Taiwan, a few European nations as well. But, you know, the impact is much more for nations where the promoter shareholding is quite concentrated, or the firms have concentrated shareholdings rather than diversified shareholdings.
So it is a form of external financing. We're understanding this correct, yeah?
Absolutely a form of external financing as far as India is concerned. And it's a very popular tool.
Can you tell us of like maybe one or two cases of family businesses where ownership actually was transferred to financial institutions and which was maybe could be categorized as a traumatic sort of like event and could have maybe warned off others from this practice?
So very recently or last year, we had the case of Z Entertainment, Mr. Subhash Chandra, who built this media giant. So Mr. Subhash Chandra pledged most of the shares of his company to raise money for another group company. So last year, Mr. Chandra lost control of his companies. We have Jet Airways, the promoter. So it was one of the largest airlines in India, and the promoter lost control of his firm.
So if share pledging in and of itself already sends sort of a negative message to shareholders, and it seems like a not worth the risk, but then there are people who do it very strategically, is what I'm understanding from you.
Absolutely, Ramesh. So in fact, this is one of the reasons why we wanted to study this phenomena in such detail, that if it is so risky, then why would it be so popular? You know, people would not really be using it so much if it was that risky and that negative.
What external factors represent a risk for companies that currently are practicing share pledging, like, you know, macroeconomically speaking?
Many of the times the promoters actually underestimate, and they believe that the money that they are raising through pledging, they will be able to make money, get good returns out of them, and then de-pledge their shares. But it doesn't happen all the time. Some firms are able to do it. The difference that we find between firms that are able to kind of do well and firms that are not able to de-pledge ultimately is that the firms which have a proper plan to, where are they going to invest? What would be the return on that capital? How are they going to de-pledge? And they have a mechanism which says that beyond this, we will not pledge any further.
Are we talking about a direct correlation with how much governance is in place in these companies, do you think? I mean, is that word being used in relation to this?
Right now, this word is not being used so much in the industry or in the media or in the companies. But we want to show that through our study, we want to make it a big theme within pledging. That governance is very, very important. It has huge corporate governance implications.
Is there a lot of research about share pledging in India at this stage, or are you touching upon sort of like a novel approach here, a novel angle, especially linking it to the family business? Like, how pioneering is this research?
I'm very happy to tell you that, yes, it is quite pioneering for us to look at this this phenomena from a family business angle. In India, there are a couple of people who are doing research in the area of pledging, but they're looking at it more from a financial angle. But what we want to do is we want to look at a more balanced view. We also want to look at it from a strategy angle.
What has been the biggest surprise for you in doing this research where you were like, oh my God, I did not expect this. Like, and this is really not something that we thought we would find.
We were taken aback by the scale of the potential loss of ownership control that so many firms face and the associated impact that it will have on the promoting families and other stakeholders of the companies. Because on an average in India, promoter shareholding of all firms, all listed firms, is about 50%. So most of the promoters, I would say an average promoter, actually has ownership control, a slight majority ownership control of the firm. But if we take out the part that is pledged, and if we were to assume that they might end up losing control of the part that they have pledged.
I find this very interesting how you talked about there actually being cases where maybe the decision to do this is not actually really being discussed within the current ownership structure, which of course can be highly problematic. So why do you think this conversation could be potentially difficult for a family and for family business owners to have?
It would be good to create more awareness about this phenomena, because the impact is so high. You know, it's not about losing a few millions here and there. It's about losing your entire firm. So the impact is so large that creating awareness amongst all family stakeholders is very important.
Businesses have to do so much to be listed on the stock market, right? Like, so what does the regulatory side look like for share pledging, and how can that be a protective mechanism for family businesses?
There have been ongoing disclosure requirements which are introduced by SEBI, which says that you must disclose the purpose for which you're pledging. Is it personal? Is it for another firm? Is it for the same firm? However, it's not being followed up quite well. So the disclosures, if you look at the data on disclosures, there are just blanket statements like for loans. Now, for loans for what? For working capital, for long-term reasons, for expansion, for, you know, marriage, education. So loans for what? We don't know. Similarly, the Reserve Bank of India, which is the central bank of the country, that has actually warned the market a number of times that pledging of the exposure of financial institutions and banks to pledging of shares, it is so large now that it can become a systemic issue in the future.
From this first paper, like when you talk to a family who's about to practice share pledging, like what would be sort of like your key pieces of advice from what you've done so far in terms of the research?
Right. So my first thing would be, don't get into a pledging trap. The second point would be to have transparency, communicate well. Because a lot of times, lack of communication actually accentuates the negative impact. And the third thing would be to use the money well and not take it for granted.
Incredibly useful advice here coming from Nupur. Thank you so much, Nupur. We're, of course, delighted to hear that you'll be digging deeper into this topic. Tell us a little bit more about what we get to expect from future research.
So we would like to evaluate the risks, rewards, and motivations of the promoters when pledging their shares. We're also going to look at pledging from an entrepreneurial financing angle. We would also like to do a lot of case study-based research in order to understand the nuanced variations in promoter choices and the causes and consequences of their decisions.